Welcome back to the Wet Shavers Roundtable number 15. We are here with a very special guest, Christian Lévesque. And how are you doing today, sir?
Christian is actually muted at this point. I can see it muted.
We're good.
There you go.
Myself, I didn't want to interfere with anything, I know, great. I'm not going to be speaking for. So I'm doing very well. Thank you very much for inviting me, and I'm looking forward to this fun and engaging show.
Yeah, man. And as always, we have the truth, David Gonzalez. How are you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing good, man. I have a question, though. Every time you do that beginning, are you always going to be the Wet Shavers Roundtable, like 964, if it actually gets to that point?
Why not? I don't know.
I'm just wondering. I was like, man, the weird stuff that pops into my head, I was just wondering, like, damn, what if this show does become a success and we're doing it for the next 10 years? And, yeah, episode 1,034 and a half.
That would be pretty epic. That would be nuts. And then, as always, we've got our captain, Douglas Smythe, who has been on crazy travels across the country, not the globe, but...
Part of the globe.
Yeah.
I'm doing great. It's great to be here, Christian. Welcome to the show. I hope it's smooth sailing for the rest of the show. We seem to be having a little bit of technical difficulties here. Yeah. But I hope the
G-Plus is a freaking disaster.
I don't know.
God damn it, dude. Every
it's
week
listening.
It's fine. So, if they are listening, G-Plus, you're an asshole. Can you fix this, please?
And the truth is speaking.
Yes, yeah. He is. And also, I wanted to mention, if you guys haven't noticed, I'm really digging Douglas's shirt today. The Mogwai shirt, that's a classic right there. I love Gremlins. That was like one of my favorite.
Instructions.
That was one of my favorite shows. Don't put it in water. Movie. Don't feed it after midnight. And you'll be good.
Gizmo has to be one of the cutest creatures ever in all of movies.
Totally.
So guys, the truth just said, you guys are all Furbies, and I know what you're going to get dressed as on Halloween.
So, guys, if you're out there watching the show, as always, you can be a part of the conversation at WS Roundtable, and you can chat with us, be a part of the conversation. Or if you are on YouTube watching this, you can go to the Q&A section. There should be a link. Send you over to it, and you can write us questions there. We will try to answer them the best we can. We don't get to all of them, but we try to answer a lot of them. But this week, we've got a whole lot of cool stuff to talk about. As you know, we are down two men. Marty is doing drills, and Khan is still doing work. I don't know what he's doing exactly, but he's down
pills.
In Australia.
I hope somebody message Khan
drills and
tell
pills,
him,
people. Drills and pills.
Can somebody tell Khan that nobody is really that busy? So for him to miss 3 weeks in a row is unacceptable. Tell his ass to get on.
David, there are people that busy. I'm one of those people that busy.
Yes,
your ass is always here, even when you have people in the. You're
that's
in a
how
bar
awesome
you contact
I am.
Us. Or
know.
Addicted.
You can't get rid of me.
So, guys,
I know we're scheduling meetups across the country in hopes that you won't come on Saturday.
Next one you're at, bitch.
I do want to talk about that later in the show. I want to hear how things went. It looked like it was a pretty epic meetup. But before we do that, so people can get to know our guest a little bit better, I like to do a small Q&A. And then, if you guys have questions for our guest, feel free to ask out there on Twitter. And for our rest of the panel, David and Douglas, if you have questions for Christian, please feel free to ask at any time. So, Christian, so people out there can get to know you. I am in the description. I said you're a wet shaving enthusiast. You are a attendee of a barbershop. From time to time, you carry epic mutton chops right now. At one point in time, you have had a very distinguished and awesome mustache. So my first question, which I pretty much ask everybody, is how'd you get into wet shaving?
Well, it was it happened a really, really long time ago, actually, over 10 years ago, where I tried using a brush and regular hard soap. Didn't work out too well, but I was intrigued. And then last April, I had some time to spend in a mall that had Art of Shaving. I had my daughter with me, and I just walked in, and the guy gave me a speech, and I was very intrigued. But then I saw the sticker, the prices on their items, and I thought, well, that's interesting, but I'll try to find something on the internet. So I spent a crazy, 72 hours searching everything obsessively every moment that I was awake, and I ended up, building a kit. And in doing that, you start looking at all the forums, and so you get involved with that, and those are other, like, rabbit hole enablers.
Yes.
So, once I started doing that, then, you have to get razor blade samples, and the ordering, the online ordering just happens. Although I live in a city where you can go to a store and get a lot of the stuff, I love the comfort of the home and the peace and quiet, and I can do my own thing. I don't have to worry about traveling. And so I got involved, and then with all the Facebook groups and G+, I'm with the How to Grow a Mustache community, as well as a French-based shaving community. So that's how I got involved. It was just a question of I didn't shave much before because it bothered me, and I tried this option, and it worked out really well, and yeah. I enjoyed it, and I realized, the Zen benefits of it, the mindfulness of concentrating on one thing outside of everything else, and it's worked out really well, and I've gotten more involved to the point where I no longer ridicule shave of the days, because I used to look at them saying, man, those guys are deep nerds, and now I'm part of that group, and I now write blog posts on the How to Grow a Mustache blog, and I'm doing
yes.
interviews with different people, and last year I got involved with Movember and started off with a horseshoe mustache and transformed that into a handlebar mustache, and then decided to keep it for a while. So I had it for 7 months, and had never been trimmed. That had only been combed and waxed and cleaned and moisturized. And then I cut it off and I shaved it off. I did my first shaving video. So I think I've touched a lot of the bases here.
Yeah.
And
that was a sad day when you shaved that mustache. That would be one of the most awesome handlebar mustaches I've ever seen in my life. It was,
I know.
It was pretty damn amazing.
It was.
I totally cried that day because it was awesome. And something else, if you guys are watching, and if you're in any of the groups, if you might remember this, but Christian would post some pictures that I just totally loved. His daughter, how old was she at the time? She's pretty little.
She had just turned 5 because her birthday's at the end of October. So
yeah, and Christian was telling me the other day, I guess she was just learning to write. So she would write the sign, and they would say something like day 1, day 2, day 3, and they went through all these different days, and they would do these cute pictures together, and it was just awesome to see the progression of the mustache and just kind of seeing you and your daughter doing that was really awesome. I really love those pictures. So I'm hoping you do something like that again, because it just was, it was entertaining and it was encouraging for me personally. So you mentioned you do blogging. So how did you get into that? What made you want to blog about wet shaving? Because you were talking about Shave of the Days being nerdy. Blogging is like a whole nother level of being a nerd.
Watch your mouth, buddy.
I know. I do videos. I'm just saying.
Well, look, just to address, I've already started this year, so Rico, you don't have to worry. As you can see, that orange rectangle in the background there, those are 4 little felt mustaches that I think my daughter Brigitte will be wearing during the month of November.
Nice.
So I want to do something a little different, but I want to, like, she's the best. She's the star. She's the, she's not a prop. I'm the prop. She just has to smile and everyone, enjoys it. So I'm going to keep that formula. I'm just going to change a couple of variables in it or a couple of quantities. And so I'm in that. Now, the fact that you guys cried when I shaved, I know I still have work to do to become a bigger nerd, shaving nerd.
I wrote a poem. It was an ode.
Yes.
Yeah, I know. I was kind of condemned when that happened, but I let everyone know that there's still hope, that Movember's coming around, and I'm not sure what I'm going to do this year. So yeah. That's one thing, but...
Should we put it to a vote? We should ask the audience, what do you think he should grow at? A pencil, mustache, handlebar, one of the classic Hulk Hogan mustaches.
Or how about a Charlie Chaplin?
Yeah.
Yeah, see how far that gets you.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially
that worked for Jordan that I'm in LA. As baseball.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. No, Christian, so I'm not sure if anyone knows this out there, and I'm not sure if we've covered it yet because I guess I wasn't paying attention, but Christian is the captain of
yes.
the official How to Grow a Mustache Movember team. He is running the United States team, and his cousin, Daniel, is running the Canadian team. I had no idea they were related when I hired them. It's this fluke thing. But I just want to tell everyone out there listening and watching, if you want to get involved in Movember this year, please check out Christian's team. I guess it's our team.
Yep.
He is the captain. I'm just the drunk second base coach. But the address to get there is Movember Team Hitgam, htgam.com. So
yep.
That's how you get to our U.S. team.
And
I just wanted to bring that up.
And just so you guys know, if you're following on YouTube and you're watching this doing the chat, there should be a section called Showcase. And I have that link down in the Showcase. I will put that in the description box once this goes public on YouTube, so you guys can have the link to the Movember team, which we do want to talk about, and we will get into that in a second. Christian, what aspect of shaving is your favorite?
Oh, that's without a doubt applying the aftershave. That is the icing on the cake. There's no doubt about that. I mean, I do like the first pass when you're shaving. Putting on, building the face lather, because I'm a face latherer. I did purchase a Shave Market bowl, and I tried it for a couple of weeks, and I just couldn't attain the lather that I get with face shaving, face lathering. So that's good, but really the aftershave part to me is the icing. It feels great. It smells great. It's pretty much the final act in the grooming process.
Yeah.
So that's definitely my favorite part.
Yeah. Last question before we get into the nitty gritty of everything else. Are you secretly Captain Hook?
Well, there's no secret.
Yeah, it's Captain Hook's was there for 7 months. Yeah. I made a Bay Rum aftershave and named it Captain Hook's.
Oh, wow.
The shaving, the walking of the plank for Captain Hook's was videotaped. he's out there, and his spirit lives on. This year, who knows what facial critter is going to be on my... I'm going to be growing, but I'm quite certain there's a character that's going to come out of that. And
awesome.
He may be named Captain Hooks. I'm not sure.
Well, now, guys, this is the part where we get into highlighting gear that we're excited about and liking to use. So I will kick it off with the truth this time. David, what do you got for us?
Okay, well... First is a little bit of a backstory to this. These things kind of came, and the way I got them came in a very special way to me. It was a very rough week for me. My grandmother passed away earlier this week. And
I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Really sorry to hear that.
It was her time. You know, she had lived. Was already in a bad place with her illness. So it's a relief that it happened now, as opposed to prolonging it later. But again, I always speak on the generosity and the kindness of the community. And yeah. On two separate days this week, products arrived to me from people in the community. And it's just, those kind of gestures and people just reaching out without them even knowing anything's wrong. Nobody knew anything was wrong. I really didn't go telling a lot of people. But just the timing was just very, I guess, fortunate and ironic. And it's just... that's why the community means so much to me. So I'll start it off with a first from a new company that's coming out. It's a husband and wife duo, which, of course, I appreciate because you guys all know that I do things with my wife. We do the videos together and whatnot. It's called K Shave Works.
Yeah.
Now, they sent us a soap for both me and my wife to try. It's called Grape-alicious. Let's see if you guys can see that.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow, yeah. Grape soda.
Yep, it's a grape soda, and they got it spot on. I'll tell you that right now. I haven't tried it because I want the initial use to be both me and my wife shaving with it at the very same time.
Yeah.
So I decided to go ahead and we'll hold off. We're probably going to do it midweek and release the video, both of us. So this is awesome. This is, smells great. And then also something that Kelly, the wife, obviously in the duo, she asked me what kind of colors does my wife like. And I told her we're big Dodger fans. She loves blue. And she actually sent this brush right here for my wife.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah, it's a synthetic knot, hand-turned. Just really cool. Just really cool in general. I don't know how well the picture comes out on this, but it's just, it's a very beautiful and unique handle, too. It's just very vase-like, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
So that's really cool. My wife really liked that. And then now from another gentleman named David, I believe you say his name, Bradner. He just messaged me, asked me if I've tried the Barrister Man Lather Sandalwood.
Yeah.
And I said, no, I haven't tried it. Obviously, I plan on trying it because I love anything made sandalwood. So, but he's like, you know what? I appreciate the contributions you do to the community. I love watching your videos. I want to send it out to you. And, you know, what do you say to that, man? Just, I really, really appreciate it. So, Lather arrived. He ordered it from Justin Park over at Shave Revolution. And not only that, he even threw in another soap by Shaver Heaven called Mayan Musk.
Rainbow loves that.
Both smell. This Mayan Musk is incredible. It's absolutely awesome. That was great. And it has sandalwood in it too, so that's even better. I don't know if you guys can even see that.
He's a sandalwood fiend, guys. He's
freak of the week.
Yeah, that's just my thing. I'm sorry, it is what it is. And this sandalwood by Barrister and Man is not a pure sandalwood. It actually has currant and amber in it. And this is just like very sweet. This is like a candied sandalwood. The currant really adds that candy sweetness. It's very nice. So I'm looking forward to using all these products in the coming weekend.
Yeah, Barrister and Man, awesome. I don't want to misspeak, but it's William Carius, right?
And his
mom. William and his mother Paula.
Man, I know their stuff is kind of out there. Like I bought a sample pack of their stuff a while back, and I'm now just getting to it and trying to go through it to see which one I really like. But their stuff is really interesting. It's kind of out there, and I know some guys it's kind of that puts them off a little bit because it's just different. It's not what you expect. Like Leviathan, I love that stuff. That stuff smells awesome, especially with my brush that smells like coffee. Those two scents mixing together is weird. But William's got a great nose, or his mom. I'm actually not sure who comes up with the scents, but they're pretty awesome scents. I dig it.
It made it kind of hard for me to find a scent that I like because a lot of their scents are very, very complex. So even though I'm great because I had people send me samples real early on in my wet shaving journey, so to speak, but the scents were just, I couldn't really put my finger on them. They were just a little too much for me.
Yeah.
But as of recently, I've been able to find ones that I really love. Like I love Seville. I love that Salarian. Adagio is great. And this one right here is fantastic.
Awesome.
You know, there's another company that does some pretty complicated or, you know, sophisticated scents. I mean, we all know that Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements does that as well.
Yes, but they do.
There's Los Angeles Shaving Soap Company. And I don't think they're involved much in any social media platform, and they don't advertise or anything, but some of their soaps are very layered is a word I'm going to use. Yeah.
You said LA Shaving Company.
It's unfortunate with those ones because I honestly feel their scents are a little muddy. Their quality of soap is great. I actually love the performance of them, but their scents are a little much. My opinion, of course.
Yeah. They're kind of pricey, aren't they, Christian?
But it depends. There's some soaps that are pricey because he's using certain types of ingredients that aren't standard, as well as I believe he donates a portion of the sales.
Oh,
so, you know, I don't know what that is, but and I haven't done a how many lathers per, you know, I know there's a dollar per ounce cost you can do to figure out pricing.
Yeah.
You also have
I think the dollar per ounce thing is kind of dumb. It really makes unless it's the same product going for different prices.
Yeah.
Why would you, I mean, every soap is made out with different ingredients, different costing ingredients. Yeah. Like dollar per ounce really makes no sense to me at all.
Kicked that off, Douglas, and I'm sure you already know this, but Nick Shaves, I think, kind of was the one that kicked that off because
I've heard it for years. I've heard it for other people doing it too, and it's just a big mistake. It's filler during a review, but it really doesn't make any sense. Because I know my ingredients are completely different than, let's say, Mama Bear's. So to compare dollar per ounce makes absolutely zero sense.
Yeah. So the better comparison is how many shaves you get out of a puck, and then figure out, you know. So I'm working on that. I've got one from one company down, and I'm working on a hard soap. The pumpkin 3.14. I'm losing patience now. Once I'm done that, I'm going to go back to changing soaps more often because I have a roster sitting behind me just hankering to get used.
Yes, we can relate to that. So I don't know if those are the ones items you're wanting to highlight, or do you have some gear you actually want to touch on, Christian?
Oh, I thought you were going back to David because I interrupted him.
No, David.
Oh, no, I'm done. I've had my moment in the sun now. It's all you now, Christian.
Well, real quick before we jump
back. Are you on the toilet, David?
Yeah. No, I am in the restroom, but I actually have my desk chair in here. My toilet's over here.
Yeah,
to this side.
Yeah, right. It's desk chair.
I actually before I turn
my friends on the can.
Yeah. Yeah.
The lighting in my restroom is like the best in my house. I don't know who exactly designed this house, but it's one of the dimmest and darkest houses I've ever been in. It's like a dungeon here. So the restroom is actually the best lighting.
You know, and you bring up a good point, and I remember this every time I'm shaving, and I forget to bring it up when I'm giving like tips away, but lighting in the bathroom, not only is it great for a video, it's also great for shaving. Equal lighting on both sides of your face. People never talk about that, but lighting is so important to your shave den.
You hit the nail on the head. I was at on vacation. We were at a rental house, and this bathroom that I was in, first of all, the mirror wasn't hung, so it was hanging slanted, you know, on top of the sink. That was already a bad posture issue, and the lighting was such that it was just all reflection. But when I was doing it, I was saying, you know what? Like, what about the people that shave in the shower? Like, you know, they don't really get much for a mirror because of the steam. Yeah, so I shouldn't complain. And then I think there's a couple of members on Facebook that have that are either blind or partially blind, and they're shaving. So it's like, okay, I got a man up here, you know, suck it up. But it's true, though, that lighting does make it a whole lot different and better.
Yeah.
I have a light in my shower above my head, so it's like equal, like on both sides. And the mirror, I pour water. It has a water reservoir in the back of it for hot water, so it keeps from fogging.
Nice. Cool.
Wow, is that a built-in? Did you do it yourself, or is that
no? This is actually a shitty product. That it's really not all that, but it's giving me. I am going to be working on my bathroom very soon, and I'm going to have one made in ceramic into the wall with a reservoir in the back and a rubber stopper at the bottom that can pull out afterwards and it'll drain. But yeah, it's giving me
some
ideas.
A mirror scuttle.
Kind of, yeah, exactly.
That's awesome. Actually, that's a cool
a
model, idea.
A model.
Cool. I just have to step out.
Okay. So while he's doing that, I'll touch on the stuff I wanted to highlight real quick, and then we'll jump to Douglas.
I'm doing a show on the computer.
He forgot to mute his mic.
That's okay. I think that's where the echo is coming from. Let me see if I can take care of that real quick.
Yeah, just mute.
There we go. Okay. So for this week, I wanted to touch on a lot of times, well, not always, we don't always focus on high-end gear, but some of it is kind of high-end, like I know the ATT we kind of mention quite often in the show, and so I wanted to touch on one that has kind of become my workhorse razor. This is the Mission Razor by Razor Rock, and this thing is fantastic. I think it's based off of... yeah, we got it.
Hold on. I think is Does Christian have the show on at his house?
Yeah. No. It's his headphones. So, anyway, sorry about that. So we got the Razor Rock Mission, and it's like $20, and you get blades with this thing. And this thing just, I don't know what it is. It's grippier. I think it's based off of R89 classic head. But it's got a better grip, and it's just reasonably priced. You get a great deal with it. And if you're just starting out, I recommend this razor. It's awesome. I know, Joe, everybody loves the, the Stealth Slant, and I had a couple of those. But if you really want to just get into this, you don't need something expensive. Also, another great option is the Feather, the Douglas double open comb. There we go. I was about to blank
this
out
one on right that. Here, Ben.
Yes.
Bam.
That is another awesome razor. And I actually got my friend into wet shaving, and he asked me, hey, what should I get as a razor? Because when he first got into it, I actually recommended this one. And then for the second one, I said, well, you should try this double open comb. So he ordered it, and then he texted me and said he loved it. So that's awesome.
Nice, nice.
And then we also have Soap Commander's Commitment. People were kind of tweeting about this, that that the show's costing them money because they're watching and the stuff we recommend, they're buying it. Sorry, guys. Yes. Sorry if you're out there.
I'm not sorry.
And you're buying stuff because we're telling you it's awesome. I have to say, Darren and Carrie Seibert, oh my gosh, you did a fantastic job on this soap. This is, and David knows this, this is a sandalwood. And I haven't used it yet. I'm using it tomorrow. I got to go to a wedding.
I just shaved with it today.
Fantastic. It's a beautiful scent. It's like, I don't know, it's like cologne or something, but it's just different.
I don't know if you've purchased it yet, Rico, but the Santalum Fumus Aftershave pairs wonderfully with it. It's available at phoenixshaving.com. Also, the soap is at soulsharplimited.com.
Where can I get those again? Say it again.
The soap is now available at soulsharplimited.com, and the aftershave is available at phoenixshaving.com.
Fantastic.
Shameless plug. but seriously, though, it does go really well. I used it right now on a video, and it's awesome.
We're having a David moment. I feel like I'm in one of your videos.
You are.
And then lastly, I wanted to highlight the coffee. I ordered coffee. People kept bugging me about trying this. It's been on my list. I've been wanting to try Soap Commander's Coffee. This is a Mexican single origin. So, Noah Seibert, well done, sir.
Oh, I thought it was single orgy. I was like, how does that work?
Single.
I had one of those earlier.
Oh, my gosh.
I don't even know what that means. More wine.
All right.
We all know what that means.
Christian, so that's what I have for this week. Christian, what do you got for us that you'd like to highlight real quick? And then we'll jump over to Douglas. And then, Douglas, I want you to talk about the Boston meetup. Tell us what went on down there. So what do you got, Christian?
All right, so this week what I've been doing is I'm not a bomb person, but I got this at a significant discount in exchange for a review on Amazon. It's Barbary Coast's Bay Rum Bomb. So I've used it a few times, and I really like it. I mean, the price point for this is pretty high, so I figured the product can't be horrible. It's passable at a minimum and could be excellent. But seeing as I'm not a bomb guy, I still feel a layer on there, but it works well. My skin is happy with it, and it smells like great bay rum. I love the metallic clover kind of scent. I don't know if that's a good description. Maybe you, Rico, or Douglas could clarify if I make sense when I'm doing that. But I'm comparing it with this aftershave that I absolutely really enjoy for bay rum. It's Cat O' Nine Tails from Captain's Choice. It's really good. And then next week, in terms of comparison, I'll be adding Le Prince Barbu, an artisan from Montreal, Alexandre Le Prince.
Nice.
And I've used his aftershave oil, but this is an aftershave kind of a witch hazel comb. I can't even see all the ingredients. Oh, it's alcohol based, so it's a pure splash, but it's made of bay rum. So he's making this recipe, and because a lot of the French people that he interacts with on his own G+ community, the one that I'm a member of, are in France and Switzerland and Belgium. He wants to make sure that he can export it over there. So he wanted to nail down this aftershave and then do something that he can export out of Canada or North America easily. So the three that I'm working on. I really enjoy bay rum. My wife doesn't, so it's not something that I'm going to be able to wear for the rest of my life on any day. I do it on days that my wife is working. That way I'm fine. Just the same with Douglas with Tombstone. I love Tombstone, but my wife, that's awesome. A major not happening. So I wear it on days that she's at work.
Well, good for you to hold on to it, though. A lot of guys will just flip it the next day in the forums. Even though they enjoy it, they flip it because they're significant others. And it's like, are you guys stuck at the hip all the time? I mean, like,
no, we're not.
Yourself, you know? Yeah.
However, there's one aftershave that my wife will smell even if I wore it like a week ago, and that's tabac. That thing is not. That
tobacco is awesome. I love tobacco.
I love it too.
I'm gonna say it. That's the biggest cock blocker I ever met.
Oh. I'm lucky. My wife loves that one. But hey, Douglas, guess what? Aftershave. My wife really does not like. And you're not gonna be happy about it.
No.
What do you think? Do you think?
Centella Fumis?
Alphine.
Oh, what? No.
She does not like it, dude. My wife does not like Alphine.
Wow. I don't know what it
is. No me gusta para nada.
My wife's not super keen on Alphine either. So just so you guys know, if Tabak is watching, we are not, the words expressed in this show are not endorsed by everybody here. We're just saying. So Christian, is that all the items you got for us over there?
I think I stirred it up enough. Yeah, that's good.
And Christian, if you just so you know, so you're not bugged or anything. Sometimes I'm hearing an echo, and I'm not sure why. So if your mic's muted and you didn't mute it, I'm just doing it so there's no noise. But anyway, just technical stuff. G+. So Douglas,
Rico,
yeah, what's up, man?
If I may, before we get on to Douglas, if I could ask Christian if he has tried the Barbary Coast. Shave soap, because I have been considering trying it, but it seems to be a little bit expensive, and I believe it's a melting pour, but I'm not sure. So have you tried that by any chance?
No, I haven't. I've been intrigued by them just because what they do. Like I follow them on Instagram, and all their pictures have a certain style. They're pretty cool looking pictures, and I saw their products, and if I'm not mistaken. I think they might be based in. They're based in Arizona, actually. So, it says. I think it's. If I can read here, I'm tromboning because I'm like an old guy now. Is it Southdale? No, does that make sense?
I don't
know.
No,
it doesn't. Let me reach back for my
glasses,
magnifying glass,
Christian.
With
right here.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. Oh shit!
Right.
Oh come on!
It is. They're based in Scottsdale, Arizona.
Scottsdale.
Oh, okay, that's interesting. Yeah, I don't know of them.
All right, Douglas, what do you got for us?
Was that me?
Yes.
Okay. I thought we'd never get to me. But here we are, folks. I picked this up while traveling this week, and it's an aftershave balm that I don't think I've ever seen this in any Shaves of the Day or heard anyone speak of it or review at that. But it's called Bulldog Skincare for Men. Have you guys seen this?
No, never.
It's
yes,
pretty cool.
Yes, I have. I don't know where I've seen. I might be at the shave shop I've got in town, but I've not used it. So how is it?
It's awesome. I like it better than Nivea, and it's 8 essential oils, green tea, konjac, mannin, rosehip oil, vitamin E. It's great. It's got some really great ingredients in here. And yeah, it feels real. I don't know if I like it better than Nivea. I probably like them equally. But yeah. This is something, if you want to try something different or something new, check that one out.
Douglas, just so you know, somebody on Twitter, they said we should have a graphic going, like an animated thing that's tallying up how much stuff people's buying as they're watching the show.
That would be awesome.
That would be awesome. Okay, now let's see what I got. What I have over here this week is, well, this is kind of not really I think I'm done with what I have to, what I've been talking about. Since I've been traveling, I don't really have much that I've been using that's different. I mean, I will touch upon different sample soaps and products I've received at the meetup and whatnot, but I just wanted to touch base with some of our audience that is familiar with PAA and the release is coming up. Inside House 5 is coming out this Monday, so just a heads up to people about that. So, and we'll also have the matching cologne slash aftershave. And then Tea Party 508.
That's also cool.
With matching aftershave. I especially made this for the meetup. It was only available for people at the meetup until Fran like twisted my arm and said, no, you need to make it for everybody because people are really digging it. And this is like, this would smell like the harbor, sea salt with every one of your favorite teas tossed in it.
Wow.
So, yeah, and a little bit of tobacco. So that's
Two more soaps I'm adding to my list here.
And then, it was funny, while I was away this week, I visited with my best friend Brian and his little son River, he's like 8 or 9 years old, runs up to me, he's like, you know, Doug, do you have a deodorant for kids? I was like, what are you talking about? I didn't use a deodorant until I was in high school. But this kid stinks. He really did stink. And so I was like, you know, I hadn't thought of it until now, but you know, I'll work on that. And in the meantime, like probably a couple hours later, I get a text from my sister who was wondering if I was going to come visit her because she had some questions. And one of the questions was from her son, who's about 8 or 9 years old, asking me if I made a deodorant for kids. It's so weird, but I mean, they're both athletic kids.
Yeah.
So I came back, and I've been in the shop all morning, and I came up with this.
Nice.
I don't know if you can see that, but that is Little Stinkers Pit Stop deodorant for kids.
That's true. My niece just turned 9, and my sister-in-law was telling me she just had to have a sit-down with my niece and say, hey, you smell.
Yeah. So apparently this is the new thing. I don't remember that. You know, maybe it's what the kids are eating nowadays, but so I got to work on it, and this is all natural. I don't use any fragrance oil in this. What I do use is fragrance oils that are derived from plants. They're plant-derived natural fragrance oils. So there's nothing toxic in this at all.
Nice.
Nothing synthetic, nothing sketchy. And this is my first one. It's Citrus Zinger, and it almost has like, it smells like Pop Rocks. And so it's for boys or girls. It's pretty much, it's nothing too, you know, mature, like a musk or something like that. I don't want to get down that road so early, but this will definitely cover up the stank. And, you know, it smells like candy, like something kids would really dig.
Nice.
They wanted root beer. Both of them wanted root beer. This is coming from two different kids. Yeah.
Well, with that, would you pair it with like some alum in order to make it an antiperspirant? Because my stepson, he's a sweaty human being. So I need to figure something out for that.
It's funny you say that, because when I was talking to the kid, when I was talking to River, I was saying, you know, in the meantime, if your mother has the crystal, they're into health food store stuff. So I was like, if you have the rock, the crystal rock, the alum rock, use that.
Yeah.
And and she was concerned. She was like, you know, is this aluminum? And I was like, no, alum isn't. You know, alum is... it's a salt, you know, I mean, it's not aluminum, it's just, it's potassium alum, it's not absorbed into the bloodstream, so on and so forth, so I had to, you know, a lot of people have freaked out about aluminum and stuff like that, and, you know, whether they should or shouldn't be, I don't know, there's still, you know, there's different results for depending who's taking the test out there, and a lot of the time, you know, there's more aluminum in an antacid pill than there is in the deodorant you're putting on your arm, and, you know, using that after a year, so consider that. And then lastly, to shift back into the original gear, can you see that?
Yes.
You hear me talking about these cloths?
Those things are awesome.
Polishing razors. This stuff is awesome. Right after a shave, I was using sunglasses, you know, for my sunglasses, I was using it on it, but I had to have them made. And so I think I'm going to include these with my razors or sell them. I don't know, or pass them out at events, but yeah, they're great.
You definitely
razor
should.
Cleaning cloths.
Yeah, those are awesome, man.
So that's what's been going on. Now, to touch upon the meetup.
Yes.
For those who are interested. It was
just
the
before
most...
You, just before yes. you move on, I want to touch back on your deodorant for the kids. I think my daughter would just like that just for the fun of it. That flavor, the Pop Rocks, would be really cool, you know, yeah. like cotton candy kind of sweetness. And I agree with you about, yeah. you know, adding mature scents might be too much. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm definitely going to be ordering that when you get that. But yeah, there's also...
I'm sorry?
I just want to say that I use Razor Rock's alum spray. It's unscented, mm-hmm. and the notion, all alum does is kill the bacteria that you perspire that creates this stink. So the other stuff, could be basically a waxy cover on your skin to stop this stink from coming out, I think, and just sense it. But when you have alum in it, you're doing the work that has to be done to get rid of the smell. So I think that's fantastic. I just wanted to yep. mention that the spray, I've been using that, and I think it's the bomb. It doesn't do anything on the creases of your, you know, underarm or whatever.
Yeah.
And it's yeah. easy to apply, and I know it's 100% safe. Yeah. yeah. So anyway, sorry.
Yeah, no,
that's great.
Alum, I'll use Alum if I'm on the way to the gym. I'll put that on first, and then I'll put my deodorant on top of it because I make a deodorant. Yeah. I don't do an antiperspirant. In combination, those work really well together, especially if you're not going to hop in the shower after the gym and maybe go to work or whatever else afterwards. So I keep that in mind. For the kids' deodorant, though, I didn't really want to go down that route. I'll recommend it if you know parents want to try Alum on their kids, by all means. I don't see a problem with that. There hasn't been any toxicology found in around the use of Alum in adults yet. It doesn't mean there's not going to be. So but with this, I just wanted to keep it I think I have 9 ingredients in this. I wanted to keep it very simple and not complicate it too much. So that's what I was going for that. In the future, who knows where it's going to go. Again, this is Citrus Zinger. There's going to be more coming out. I think I'm going to do a strawberry, an all-strawberry one, too, for little girls. Cool. I think that'll be neat. Maybe with, a matching, tonic or splash or something like that. I don't know. I'm just having fun with it. I never even thought of it. I don't have kids, so I don't think about this stuff.
But, the kids want to imitate their parents. They want to imitate their parents, and they see all that stuff. They get to see what's going on in the bathroom. And, I don't know if sending a product to, environmentalworkinggroup.org, they do all these chemical tests on different products and foods that people eat. And I think a lot of health-oriented people check out those. I checked that out for sunscreen, actually, and I made my selection based solely on, the reports that they come out with, because there's so many chemicals floating out there. You have to be, kind of careful if you want to be as healthy as possible.
Yeah, exactly.
It's true. Don't open the windows.
Not in L.A., don't.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Meanwhile, you live in L.A.
They should have an Instagram filter called Los Angeles to get that beautiful orange smile.
Yeah.
So,
back to the meetup. It was epic. There was 50-plus people in attendance there. There might have been more. Some of you have seen the group photo. The group photo doesn't do it justice because that was taken probably the last 15 minutes of the gathering. So people were coming and going throughout the night. And so a lot of people had already left. In fact, Fran didn't make that group photo. She left right before that. But, it was insane. It was just, it was in the back of a restaurant, first of all, of this bar, this brewery. So we had all the, we had all these last supper-sized tables to ourselves. We had about 5 of them. And then on the other side of the room, I was set up with all the, the giveaway stuff that a bunch of artisans across Shavedom have donated. And I'd like to thank, I wish I had a list with me, I have no foresight, but I'd like to give a shout-out to all the artisans that did participate. And we will have more meetups in the future for those who didn't get a chance to participate. But if you can't make it to a meetup, at least send your products there as door prizes, and I will do my best to get the word out that you were part of it. Especially at the meetup. I was passing out business cards, passing out there. We just had this huge raffle. It wasn't really a raffle. They weren't buying tickets, but they were door prizes. And we gave away so much stuff. It was amazing. Everyone walked away. People, when they're going to a meetup or announcing that there's a meetup happening, people are always contacting me, asking me, what are you bringing? They're just assuming we're selling something.
Yeah.
What are the artisans selling? Typically at a meetup, artisans and vendors, we don't sell stuff. We go there, we want to schmooze. We don't have to accept money. We don't just want to bring stuff with us. We just want to schmooze just like you. We want to drink beer and just talk shop.
Yeah.
So we don't do that. What we do, however, is giveaways. or samples. Most of us will bring samples with us. That said, I made, again, Tea Party 508, the soap and the cologne. I passed that out. Katie's Bubbles passed out. Oh, what did Chris pass out? Cape Cod Cranberry. And,
yeah.
I have actually been shaving with that this week, too, and I will be shaving with it more this week so I can talk about it next week on our next show. Then Mickey Lee's Soapworks, they also passed out a soap, a sample soap and sample size aftershave splash, which is far out. I can't remember the name right now. It's a Middle Eastern scent that's really spicy. But it's also very fall-esque, too. I've been using that for the last few days while I was traveling. So they participated in that. But, yeah, so that's just what we do when and our artisans and vendors, when we're there, expect to get a sample or something like that. I think I got a sample from everybody, myself, and I've been using them, and I will feature them in the next few episodes.
Yeah.
I also got this group.
And also just on that, Douglas, I will vouch that Douglas does, in fact, give out the stuff, man. Nobody's keeping anything. Nobody's trying to sabotage anything.
Yeah.
All this stuff does it take. I know some people have that thought that, oh, if I send free shit, it's not going to get spread around and somebody may hoard it. No, this stuff does get around, man. Monica Gillum at the Chicago one, everybody got some of her stuff.
Yeah, it WSP sent out some stuff. And yeah,
it gets around to everybody, man. So, you know, there's some honest folks involved, so your stuff does get around to everybody.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah. Well, it's a community thing, you know. We want everyone to be part of it, whether you're there in the flesh or not. You know, so that's what we're working on here. Next, I got this. I got something.
Holy smokes.
Jeff Reidman of the How to Grow Mustache community, who's now on Facebook, he was also in attendance there. Great guy, great stash.
Hey, Jeff.
And he gave me a pipe holder.
That is
finally
awesome.
He's seen me put my pipe down on the table all the time, and he thought I needed a pipe holder. Now, let me show you this. This is really – it's almost like – Abraham Lincoln as Captain Lincoln.
Yeah, like Captain Ahab or something.
But what is look at this guy. I mean, it's perverse, really. But
what's he doing? Yoga?
He's like blocking his ears. This is like hear no evil as I bend over. I don't know what we should expect from this. I also don't know what he ate prior to this.
Doing the downward dog, I guess is what they call it.
I don't know if I call it that, but yes. Yeah.
Awesome.
So that was also given to me, but I mean, it was really epic. And then we tried to do after the giveaway, or we took a break from the giveaway, so I could try to get on the round table with you guys, as you remember.
Yes.
And you had no sound for me. I don't know what was going on there. You know, you try to make it happen, you try to do everything, but so I watched that episode, and it's just like walking around in silence.
Yes.
I swear, people, we were making noise. Wasn't anything weird going on there.
They were loud.
We were
they
all were very really loud. We were, but at that point, we were pretty drunk too, I think. But epic night, probably like 3 hours. Oh, actually, no, I'm sorry, because there was a post meetup too. We went back to my hotel bar, all of us. I mean, a lot of us, anyways. Probably about 15 of us, and just kept drinking, and it was amazing. It was just
kept drinking. No kidding.
Every meetup I've gone to so far, each one is so different from the last. They're all like fingerprints or something like that. Everyone's different, but part of the same hand, almost, if you will.
Yeah.
I just came up with that. You like that? But it was awesome. I can't wait for the next one. The next one will be
November Alabama. 7th.
Alabama. Yeah, that's right. October.
Alabama.
Oh, Dirty South. That's right, the Dirty South meetup.
Yep.
Dirty South, and I'll be there for that one. I've never been to Alabama before, so I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Get my Dirty South on.
So, yes. Guys, speaking of community, you can tweet to us at WS Roundtable. And, you got to go to these meetups, guys. If you've never been to one and there's one kind of close by or you're looking to take a vacation and you want to do something really fun, talk your significant other into going. They're just a blast. Big, big fun time.
Or allow you to go.
Yes. And continuing with the community theme, I had an announcement. Let me get over to Twitter here. Matthew.
Oh, I have an announcement too. Oh, that's the same announcement?
Oh, yeah. Okay. Brush Guy, Matthew Marting. He says, we have an auction going on for Wounded Warriors and St. Jude's, and he asked if we could mention on the show. So we are. So you can go to 32auctions.com/brushmakers. And if you guys are following us on Twitter, you can see this tweet. I'll also try to include that into the description box on YouTube. But check that out. It's a good for a really good cause. I don't know all the details. Matthew just asked if we'd mention it. So we did. Bam. So speaking of another...
He's also going to be on the show very soon, my dad.
Yes. Yeah, we do need to get him on. He makes some really great brushes. So the reason we had Christian on, and we kind of touched on it earlier, and then we'll jump into Twitter. Sorry, guys. I know you guys are commenting. There's a lot of comments we want to get to. But we do want to talk about this for a moment. Christian, the reason we had Christian on is because he is the captain for our How to Grow a Mustache Movember team. Tell us what it is, why should a guy join, and kind of fill us in on some details on this, because it's important.
His mic's off.
Sorry about that.
You forgot.
Yep, no, you're good. Hold on, let's see if we get this.
I'm back on. So Movember's been around since 2003. They've raised globally $650 million to help fund research to reduce or eliminate prostate cancer, to deal with men's health issues. So a lot of guys are, you know, not feeling well in the head. They're suicidal or they're depressed. And because of our, you know, macho culture, you don't talk about it, but it's something that has to be dealt with because it doesn't make you the best you can be. That's kind of so. And then there's also prostate cancer, there's testicular cancer, there's mental health issues, and this year, this is the most exciting part of Movember this year, is physical activity. They want to help promote people to be more active, and yes. In doing that, they've also open the door to have anyone be part of a Movember team. So people that, you know, say, I can't grow a good mustache, that's not, you know, trying to grow a mustache is what is the goal. It is not having the bushiest beard or mustache.
Thank God for that, because my mustache is absolutely pathetic when I try to grow it out.
Well, you know what? The fact that you're trying is the one that shows that you have... You know, testosterone, the fact that you're trying, I find that to be the bravest part, more than showing what it is. But more importantly is this year, there's a physical challenge, physical fitness challenge. So if you commit to doing 30 minutes of physical activity a day, then you're part of a Movember team. That is part of your activity. So I think that's really cool. As a matter of fact, I'm going to do that as well as, you know, try to grow a mustache. But and I need that. I had a physical exam this week, and that's also part of building your profile when you join a team, is to say what you're doing to ensure that your own health is optimum. And sounds like I need to clear out some arteries a little bit, so physical activity is definitely going to help me out. So just to let you know that anyone can participate. It's a great worldwide fundraising campaign to help men's issues. And I think it's, you know, it's the only one that covers so many broad bases. And what really freaks me out is that this is so complementary to traditional wet shaving because of the mustache part, because of the fact that, you know, traditional wet shavers, the people that participate in the forums, you know, are 95% are men. And so we should all be, you know, strongly encouraging this either by participating on a team. And there's a U.S. team. It's Movember team. htgam.com, and there's a Canadian contingent this year. It's that's right, the HTGAM A team.
Yeah.
Which is kind of funny. It's great, and it is a coincidence. It is my cousin Daniel Desrosiers, who's the captain of that team, and we're working right now on increasing on doing recruitment, so to have more members. And then once, you know, the end of October and November rolls around, we'll be looking at, you know, soliciting for donations. But until then, the idea is to have more people participate. And it's good for many reasons. One of them is it makes more people looking for money. But it's good because once you participate, you become aware of these things for men's health issues, and you can help yourself. You know, you could extend your life, for crying out loud. So join Movember if you want to live longer.
Yeah, and guys, it's really cool. I'm sitting here looking at the website right now, and they've got a section called Your Health if you want to check out and see what they're supporting. Just as an example, it says prostate cancer, the facts. Prostate cancer is the second most commonly diagnosed cancer in men in the United States. Know the facts, take action. Then just says stuff like 1 in 7 men are diagnosed with prostate cancer in their lifetime. 1 American dies from prostate cancer every 19 minutes. So what is that? How many guys have passed away in the show, an hour and a half show? I mean, that's insane. In 2015, an estimated 220,800 American men were diagnosed with prostate cancer. Christian said, it's for men's health, poor mental health, physical activity. And I can relate to the physical activity. Like you just said, I had some kind of a checkup, I guess, for my insurance, health insurance. And I've got insane high triglycerides. And I think it's genetics, but it's something I need to stay active with because I've just had family deaths and stuff that are kind of related to this. And like you said, Christian, this helps extend your life. It helps make you be more aware of your health. It's for a good cause. And also, I think every guy, at least once in their life, should try growing a beard, should try growing a mustache, and should shave their head. Those three things. You don't have to do you don't have to do two of those things, but for this, you know, if you can grow a mustache,
What about grow your hair long?
And you should grow out your hair, because that is equally important, too. I had a Kurt Cobain phase at one point in time. So yeah, Christian.
I never did.
If
I had a Jim Morrison phase.
So, Christian, if guys wanted to find this website, say that website one more time for us.
So the U.S. Movember team that certainly has a strong wet shaving focus is the Movember team, how to grow a mustache, MovemberTeamHTGAM.com. Once you get there, you sign up and you choose what you want to do, grow mustache or physical fitness or both.
Yeah.
And you're part of the team. We have 42 members right now. It's only been 9 days since we created the team. And we're quite happy with that. And you know, once you join, fill out your profile completely. Put a picture up. You might even donate to yourself. You want to lead by example, so you want to let people know that, you know, this is legit. Fill out your profile, and you're all set. And we're going to have prizes for members of the team. So Mo members, we'll have different contests. You know, it's not just a question of who raises the most money. There's different ways to motivate people, and we'll have raffles for the donors on the teams. So there's tons of ways to have fun with this, and I think we should have fun. The beauty is we're doing some good in the world, and we're helping them live longer. And then let's add on to this, it means we can shave more. So come on, guys.
Exactly.
So
it takes talent to shave for a mustache.
Yes, that is true, especially with the straight razor. It takes nothing to cut off some whiskers. But I also want to make sure, too, that the Canadian team is represented here, and that's the HTGAMATeam, EHTeam.com. There's
some dashes in there.
Yeah, HTGAM-EH-TEAM.com. This team, there's 7 members today, and I do know that there's going to be quite a few more that are going to join later in October. But the earlier you join, the more prepared you are, mentally, at least, to start November 1st. But you can make sure that you've got all your ducks in a row and your profile is filled, and maybe even try to help out Daniel in any type of activity that he wants to do. So I strongly encourage everyone to join Movember. It's a good time. That's the main thing. You know, this isn't dreary. This is a good time. So let's try to do a good cause and have a good time.
Yeah,
exactly. I'd like to add something to that. So if you're a vendor or an artist out there and like to participate as well, our team, you can actually donate prizes to the team, be them soaps or brushes or whatever else. We could use everybody's help out there to make this more appealing for people to donate to us, or well, to our team, rather. And again, if you're maybe you're already at the gym, maybe you work out daily, and you didn't even think of growing a mustache, or you can't grow a mustache. If you're already doing the work, just join our team. It's free to join, costs you nothing.
Yeah.
And if you're already working out, you're already doing the hard part. So just have people donate to you.
And
so join our team.
Ladies can join too, right?
Yeah, Fran's on the team. Amanda's on the team. We have a lot of the artisans. Dr. John's on the team. We have Brian on the team. We have Soapy Bathman, Chris on the team. We got a bunch of people on our teams. So, again, it's free to join. Anyone can do it. I encourage all of you in Shavedom listening right now to just join. Go over there right now to Movember Team Hitgam. Movember Team AEAM.com if you're in the United States. And just sign up. Join. Either grow the stash, work out, or do both. But, I mean, like, it's again, if you're already working out, you have no excuse to join. This is for men's health, people. And, like, it affects all of us. So, yeah, there's that. And I'm sorry, and if you're in Canada, it's HTGAM hyphen EH hyphen team.com. That's HitGamAteam.com.
Cool. Nice. And
that's my two cents.
Yeah. Fantastic stuff. It's really, really great. Please, guys, check it out. It's a lot of fun also just in that season growing a mustache. And I don't know, I'm sure all you guys that have grown one or tried growing one, the reactions you get from people is pretty fun too. I enjoy that aspect of it. So let's hop on into the questions. I know we've got quite a bit, and we'll just kind of do this for the, I think, last half. So earlier, Christian, you mentioned the veg, or you mentioned a scent that that is a cock block, I guess. So this guy is saying the veg, vegetal, I guess, lilac.
You're
vegetal.
Corrupting. You're corrupting Rico.
I know.
Wow, I know. Could he have sounded any more uncomfortable with that statement right there? Jesus Christ.
Oh, sorry, guys. He said the veg shut him down yesterday. The wife, he doesn't approve. So to carry on with that, Jeff.
Most men don't approve with the veg, though. That's kind of something that you may want to.
The veg is gross, man. The veg
most
is
men
gross.
Don't even approve of that shit. So
I smelled that at Q Brothers, and it's nasty. So this guy asks.
Some people really love it, though. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. I am curious to possibly buy a bottle just to experiment with it some more, but it was not good. So shaving the lion's den, he says. My wife loves Alphine, Douglas, but she likes Otra better. So he's now asking everybody in general, what are some other significant others just can't stand? My wife, and this made me really bummed out, and I'm really confused because it's not exact, so Douglas, don't take offense, but American Blend kind of smells similar to Barbersol. I think Barbersol's different, but they're similar. My wife cannot stand American Blend. Yeah. She can't stand the fine American Blend. She can't stand that scent. She likes Cad. Well, I said Barbersol. That's funny.
I told you there's a difference.
Barbersol.
Barbersol. So, guys, how about you? Are there scents your wives or significant others do not approve of? David, you're shaking your head. What do you got?
I can never.
We already talked about this.
Well, there's actually one more that's more that there's one that's more offensive than Alphine, and that's anything bay rum. My wife cannot stand bay rum. I don't really like it either, so I guess that's okay. But yeah, my the one time I tried it, she told me to take my ass back into the restroom and wash that shit off.
It's a Latino thing. It's a Latino thing. Yeah,
she wasn't having that shit. No, so no bay rum in this house.
Bay rum is totally gringo all the way. I mean, like, that's just it is.
Jeff is telling me he's going to send me the bottle of the veg. So thanks, Jeff. I appreciate it. I'm not sure if I should be appreciative of that or not. But
yeah, you're not getting none for a couple weeks.
Yeah, Douglas.
Yeah, it'll keep cats away from your house.
Is there something that you really enjoy but your wife, or Fran, not your wife, but...
Yeah. Don't marry me that easy.
My wife just walked in the door as I'm saying that.
Yeah.
Something she can't stand that you enjoy, which is interesting because you guys make stuff together. So,
yeah, and that's just it right there. So we make stuff that we both like, and we wouldn't do it otherwise. We've had to make some custom scents for different people in the past. Well, we chose to.
Yeah.
And we weren't too keen on them at first. We were like, oh no, we'll muddle through this. But you know, when you start getting orders for that and have to make it all the time, it'll kill your spirit. So we've agreed after that never to do that again and only work with scents that we like. Otherwise, why do it? So no, everything that I make.
Yeah.
Yo.
Yeah, it's probably going to be more referencing maybe one that you from another company.
Yeah. I don't know. See, I always thought I was a lady killer with Bay Rum. especially Burt's Bay Rum. And then I was a sandalwood guy also. And I think sandalwood just smells like, you know, sex in a bottle.
Sandalwood's fantastic.
Yeah, I mean, when it's done right. But I haven't had a problem. I haven't had a problem with any of those. Not to my knowledge, anyways.
Yeah.
Guaranteed action.
We've got so many slogans going on in this show today. This is funny.
Where can people find that, David?
Yeah. So, Christian, what do you
that
got?
That is so affectionately available at phoenixshaving.com.
See, this is why we need the other guys on the show to keep us from doing this, David.
Exactly. So, Christian, is there any
other... It's like Wimbledon of advertising.
Is there any other sense your wife just can't stand?
Well, there's tobacco is the only one that is like, get that off your face now or I don't know you anymore.
Wow.
I manage now to put on stuff that I like that she doesn't like on the days that she's at work. So I get to enjoy all the scents that I want. It's been mostly on the eau de toilettes that I've worn because the scent there comes out much stronger. And, you know, it's like when I say smell me, you know, I will have just applied it. Lalix Encre Noir, she doesn't like it too much yet. Oh, it has vetiver in it, and she loves the, you know, Guerlain's vetiver. And she loves, you know, Fine's clean vetiver. So I thought, well, I was going to score with that, but I think I should have gone with the Encre Noir Sport, which apparently has a bit more citrus and vetiver in it. Even Eau Sauvage from Christian Dior.
Yes.
She associates that scent with someone that she knows. So it's not someone she dislikes. It's just it's an older lady.
Oh, wow.
I don't want that association.
That's like, funny.
How does that smell like an old lady? This is like...
That is like a man... That's a classic man scent.
Exactly. So but I do know that, you know, a lot of scents are kind of unisex, and they might not be that different. And, you know, she's smelling it not from someone who says, oh, I wonder what the top note is. She smells it like, you know, anybody else that just catches the whiff and says, that's what I think it is. So that scent is different. But, you know, she loves 4711. That's her favorite one, and vetiver
Neroli.
From Guerlain is really, yeah, that's, she really likes that, Neroli, and I'm trying to find some more bergamots, because that's still also, in the citrus family, and because I love the citrus smell, like 4711, to her description is it smells like the beach, but to me, it smells like, you know, agrumes, like citrus, it's a citrus family, and that's a scent that's, I guess, difficult to maintain over a long time, so... I guess you must apply it frequently. I don't have any, like, that's it, that's all, other than tobacco that. And quite frankly, I agree with her. Like, it doesn't do anything for me. I wore it two times. And the second time, I thought I hid it from my wife in terms of the scent when she came back from work at 8 p.m. And she smelled, there must have been something that fell on a piece of clothing, and that scent doesn't disappear unless it gets washed. And she goes, what? So it's like, okay,
well, you can go ahead and
put it in the closet. You know what? I'm going to bring that to the barbershop and give it to the guys in case there's someone over there that wants that, you know, in the nape of their neck.
You could bring it to the meetup, Christian, and give it to me. I'll take it off your hands.
Well, whichever comes first in November. When is it that we're getting together here at the Old Town Shaving?
November 7th.
November 7th.
The SoCal meetup. The Grand Shave Lodge meetup.
Grand Lodge.
The Grand Shave Lodge meetup, people, it's happening. Bring your fez.
I know. We need to have a fez dispenser.
That's awesome. That is awesome.
Right there.
Fez dispensers are cool. Yeah, that's going to be a real intimate, cool meetup. I got a lot of surprises I'm working on for that one. It's going to be really cool. Anyone attending, bring a razor. That's all I have to say, be it a straight razor or a double edge. Bring something to shave with.
Hey, and it's gonna be exciting too, man. Because again, you got people like, of course, Peter Charkalis goes to all of them. Anthony Esposito is actually supposed to make an appearance at this one. And what the hell happened to Rico?
Our fearless leader. He's been locked out. I guess I'll be taking over live here, folks. Yeah,
he's
we're
not
live.
On board anymore. He's not even on. We should. Yeah. Wow.
Damn. What a disaster that was. But now back to what I was saying though. Ray Pope is gonna try to make it to this one as well, and you know, of course, Douglas. So it's gonna be a fun meetup, man.
Oh yeah, no, it's gonna be huge, and we're still looking for more people to go. Like, these again. Ah, man, I'm so stoked about this one. Pasadena, baby, California.
Can we?
Inhale, just played last night.
Like, sort like the night before, or later on at night. No, I'm just like the main activity. But I know, like, you know, some people arrive early and some people leave late.
Oh, we always get together. Spoke. Yeah, whenever we do that, yeah. we get together like the whole week. Like after work, I'll probably drive out to Pasadena every day, or maybe I'll make you guys come drive out to my neighborhood, and we'll go eat some street food or something.
As long as I don't wear red, I think I'll be safe, right?
Yeah, but we're not in that neighborhood. You're actually safe to wear red as long as it's not like an Anaheim Angels fucking shirt. Then me and you may have problems. But aside from that, it'll be totally fine. No, but seriously, there's some restaurants that I definitely want to take some of the East Coast guys, man, some mom-and-pop spots, just to show them California, you know, because it's nice to eat at the big restaurants, burger stands out of Pasadena, but there's just something a little bit more, it's just a good vibe getting into the neighborhoods out here and actually experience what we do here.
What about the beach?
I don't like the beach. The water's filthy. And then you get sand.
You're not
your
selling this, David.
I'm just saying, you get sand everywhere. Have you ever had sand in your ass crack? It sucks.
So tell
I
you
lived
what,
on the beach.
Sunday morning, we'll go to the beach. So that'll be a great way to revitalize yourself after a big day. We'll go to the beach. I'm up for that.
He is chafing.
I never understood the desire for people to have sex at the beach, dude. It just seems so fucking inconvenient. Like, the places that sand's going to get, dude, like, Jesus Christ. That's horrible.
I had a single orgy one time at the beach. It was pretty cool.
I think that's what towels are for, but...
Dude, what the hell happened to Rico? He got back on and then disappeared.
Well, his mic's shut off, too, so that might have something to do... This might be a cry for help. He said his wife just came home, too.
Oh, that's where the cock block comes in.
Yeah. We thought we were. Yeah. Well, let's get back to some questions here. I guess I'll be emceeing at this point.
Yeah, do you have it up on your computer? Because I'm on my phone, so I can't see nothing.
Yeah. We've got one from Shaving in the Lions Down. I don't believe he's gone by that.
There
that's
goes
awesome.
Rico again.
His question is, what are everyone's favorite scents that have been released in the last 2 weeks to a month? So I guess the last 2 weeks.
Can you guys hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you, Rico. We can't. Yeah.
You're in the doghouse, huh?
Man, that was nuts. My sound just totally went out. We
looks like your power went
G+.
Out too.
I think his wife got home and started ripping out the cords. He's just trying to cover it up.
Hold on a second. Let me check some stuff real quick. Continue on, guys. I'm sorry about this. I apologize.
No, okay, so what was the question again, Douglas?
What are some of your favorite scents that come out in the last 2 weeks?
Jesus, what has come out in the last 2 weeks?
Well, I know Carl from the Shave Market has been quite nice. That also has a citrus, but a kind of I get a soapy vibe from it. But I haven't used it. All I've done is smelled the surface, so it doesn't really count. But I know that came out recently from the Shave Market and that Facebook group, and it smells really nice. I can't wait to try it.
So. I don't know if you guys touched on this because my sound just totally dropped for a good, I don't know how long that happened, but somebody was asking, let me go back to it, and you can tell me, Christian, if you talked about this or not. Michael Anthony was asking if you use pomade, which is pretty funny because we were talking about that before the show.
We're in the middle of answering a question right now, Rico.
Oh, you are? Okay, sorry.
Yeah,
so
what are your favorite scents
on the last
that have
2 weeks?
Been released in the last 2 weeks?
Okay, sorry. I just came in on the...
No, it's fine. And you, David?
I have to say that Indian Sandalwood by Soap Commander, I'm a big fan of it. I really, really enjoy it. It's another very unique take on sandalwood. You know, the sandalwood genre obviously has been around for a long time. You've been liking it since I guess you were a baby there, Douglas.
Thousands of years.
So, you know, people are trying to do little things to kind of contrast and just kind of make it step up a little bit. So, yeah, Indian sandalwood was nice because it's definitely, I can't imagine it just being a pure single note sandalwood because it's very different than anything else I've smelled.
Very cool. I have to say, the Mickey Lee Soapworks, again, it's called Souk, I believe. I believe that's pronunciation. It's S-O-U-Q. That is a really cool scent. It's really just, it was just nice. I will always associate it with this meetup because I was walking around New England this time of year wearing that. So I really enjoyed that. I'd like to thank Eric and Samantha for putting that out. And then another scent that was Katie's Bubbles, the Cape Cod Cranberry. You know, and there was another scent that Chris gave me, too. He gave me another soap sample. I haven't used it yet. I really enjoyed it out of the jar. I haven't tried it again since, or I haven't taken a whiff of it since then. I'll have to get back to you on what that was. But those are the last two weeks, unique scents outside of my own that I've been able, lucky enough to smell and try. You, Rico?
Well, for me, would be... I haven't tried it yet, but I love this. I'm loving this scent. Indian Sandalwood by, I think you just said this, David, but this Commitment by Soap Commander is fantastic. This is awesome stuff. I'm trying to think what else I've been using that I really enjoy. I just tried Barrister & Mann's Cheshire, which is really nice. It's not new, but it's new to me, I guess. So it's kind of... I don't know if that's a barbershop or what, but it's nice.
That wasn't the question.
What two new things? Well, the only real new one right now I've got is this one. Oh, actually, let me take that back because I got a sample of... I wanted to order it after the show last week, Connection, but they sold out before I could order some. But this Connection, it's like berries... Oh, it's like berries and, I don't know, cedarwood or something. Really, really great stuff. So I'm digging that. So we got that going. Sorry, guys. This is really... Before the show, we were having crazy tech issues, and during the show, I don't know what's going on. This has been very bizarre. But we apologize.
He's totally thrown off right now, dude. He's totally, like, his feathers are all ruffled.
Yeah, no, I'm just astounded at G Plus's inability.
The incompetence
at Google.
Yeah. So that's Christian, it. I'm gonna write my congressman.
Yeah. So Christian, actually, you are a pomade dude. We've kind of touched on this a few weeks back on a couple shows about pomades being a thing. I was actually really surprised by your answer before the show because we were talking about this. Christian goes to a barber. And he went today, so you're looking good, man. Your ears got lowered, looking nice. What pomade are you using today?
Today is actually an unknown pomade from my barber at Vinny's Barber Shop. I didn't even bother to ask, but he asked. He, you know, at the end of the haircut, he goes, "You want anything put in your hair?" And I said, "Yeah, sure, do me up." So he goes, "What would you like?" I said, "Look, water-based, because I don't like petroleum-based, water-based pomade," and I said, "Stronghold and High Shine." So he gave me this thing. It smells all right, but it actually feels half rubbery. So that's not too cool. But right now, what I do now, in a week, I rotate three different pomades. I'm going to show them to you guys. One is an artisanal pomade based in Los Angeles, in Long Beach, called Rex Wax. I bought this from the guy, and I got it. I learned about it on Everything Pomade. It's a closed Facebook group, it was very interesting. I like it. It applies easily, but it dries quickly, so you got to comb your hair quickly. And it smells. It's there's a lot of musk in it. And that's good. I ordered Ruzel's water-based. And that pomade applies easily. It smells. It smells. How can I describe it? To me, it has a very strong metallic taste. This is not my favorite pomade. Period. My favorite pomade. Actually, I gave it away to my friend. What's that?
Like ozone?
Yeah, it's got a. There's a chemical in there. There's a metallic chemical. I like metallic scents, but there's a metallic chemical in there that doesn't do me very well. My favorite pomade is discontinued, but the next best thing with that same company is the club guy, the Au Naturel. I love it. And I'm going to tell you why I like this. And the reason why I like this. The reason why I like this, first of all, it's wax-based, so it's nature's own frigging holding product. And it applies, you know, you got to, you know, really, here, let's show the exact my motion here, but you really got to have to heat it up and put a lot of pressure on it to spread it. But it smells fantastic. It had the cad smell, so I love that smell. Club Guy is really a nice smell as well, but it doesn't seem to be as strong, but I love it. And I don't want that to smell more than my own face, but it smells great. But what's really cool is once it's put in your hair doesn't dry up and turn crispy like with this stuff, so that if it separates, it doesn't become a strand with this bizarre shape that's on top of your head, and that's messed up. With this one here, it looks like glue. It feels like glue once it's put in. It's easy to apply. It smells great. It's got great list of ingredients, but once it's in, it's rock solid. Maybe that's because it's heavy hold, and I'm still learning about pomades. But this one here is the one that works for me, and I don't know of any other manufacturers that do that do wax. Well, I know there are other people that do wax, but I haven't researched them enough to do it. But I love this stuff, and this stuff here, people look at the price and say, oh my God, it's, I don't know, it's $18.95 or something like that. This thing will last you half a year. I went through Admiral pomade and Shiner Gold pomade, and I'm not buying them again. If I were to buy either of those again, it would be Admiral. This is the expansion of the acquisition disorder into the grooming world.
Yeah.
Now I'm into the hair. I wash my face with Juice Beauty now, which has jojoba beads, not, you know, crushed nutshells and sand to do micro fissures on your face. Jojoba beads, they melt away when you rub them. So it's like, it's bizarre. Now I've turned into a high-maintenance guy when I shower, and if I travel, it's like the dilemma is, oh, man, I used to live on a bar of soap and a towel. Now I've got a dot bag that's got so many products, and it would confuse a hair and makeup person on a movie set.
Yeah, the pomade stuff, we've touched on this before in the past. The pomade stuff is, there is a, just like the artisan soap makers, there's an artisan kind of, I don't know what you want to call it, revival going on in pomade world. And there's some fantastic stuff. Yeah, Christian was talking about cost and how long it takes you to use that Phoenix Artisan stuff. I used to buy this stuff, and I liked it. I like it. It's a big company. Was it Baxter of California? And it was like $20 a jar, and it was like kind of this tiny jar, and I'd go through it like within a month and a half or so. And ultimately, I didn't like it because it left like a weird residue in my hair after a while. So, yeah, I'm kind of on the same journey as you. I'm looking for fantastic pomades that are easy to wash out because I don't like having stuff left in my hair every day. It kind of grosses me out. Like, I kind of think, kind of random, but I kind of like dreads. I think people with dreads look cool. But the thing that bugs me about dreads is... I don't know how you wash your hair.
You don't wash dreads.
What's growing in there? Like, what's going on? So,
well, actually, I think you just put soap through it. You, like Dr. Bronner's.
Yeah,
you can rinse it through that.
Or a powder. I think a powder.
But I mean, really,
probably like a dry shampoo.
You could use I guess you could. But I mean, I know they rub essential oils in there all the time, and they do use waxes as well, red wax. But, I'm sorry, what were you going to say, Rico?
I was going to say, I don't know what you guys exactly, because I missed part of the show. You were talking about something, and a guy, Jeff Atkinson, said, Honey Noir is the other New Katie's Bubbles scent. So I'm assuming he's commenting on something you were saying a while
back. Okay.
So
Honey Noir. Okay, that's Honey it. Noir that's, sounds... Oh, really? Okay, I don't remember even hearing that name. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you. Yes.
Well, people, it seems like we're winding down to, the tail end of our show, aren't we?
Yeah, we're pretty much right there. So, Christian, one more time, talk about real quick, if you can sum it up really quickly on the How to Grow a Mustache Movember team. Tell us really quick, what's it for, how to get involved, and if people wanted to find your info, because you blog, where could they go to find that?
Well, look, if you want to shave more, if you want to live longer, if you want to help your fellow guy, your fellow buds, I encourage you to join a Movember team.
Yeah.
The U.S. team is MovemberTeamHTGAM.com, and the Canadian contingent is HTGAM-EH-TEAM.com. I encourage you strongly to join Movember. It's a worldwide fundraising campaign for men's health issues that deals with testicular cancer, prostate cancer, men's mental health, particularly the guys with the poor mental health. And I think we've witnessed some of that in some social media forums. Movement, so physical activity, healthier. Everyone has an issue with diabetes or cholesterol or bad eating habits. If you can do 30 minutes a day, I swear to God, you're not going to be craving all the crap. You're going to be living healthier. And guess what? Maybe you'll grow more whiskers and a bushier mustache. Who knows? But all I can say is I think joining the Movember campaign is something that you can say you were proud to do in 2015, and you're going to do the world a whole lot of good.
Yeah, man. Fantastic.
Amen. Amen. I feel like I should applaud. Yes. I do want to add, though, working out will grow you more whiskers because it'll boost your production of testosterone. So think about that, people.
That is
more
true.
Testosterone, never a bad thing.
And Christian, if people wanted to read your blog, read your articles that you write, where could they go?
Well, I've written 6 so far, and I'm going to write my 7th one the next couple of weeks because I'm interviewing the people at Movember headquarters here in Culver City in the L.A. County. They can go to howtogrowamustache.com. And, that blog contains all sorts of content that's produced by a variety of people. I think Douglas hosts it and contributes to it, but a lot of people write in all sorts of articles that are related to men's issues or, general things overall. A lot of the podcasts, any type of article that people want to write, they can contribute. The reason why I've got 6 is I've decided to use Douglas's platform as a way to reach a lot of people instantly instead of trying to build my own little blog and then committing to writing, every week or every month. I write something that comes to me based on my experiences as time happens. I'm not committed to doing something every week and trying to find some content. I write it as I feel, and I've done 6 in the past year, and I'm doing my 7th one in the next couple weeks.
Yeah, woo-hoo. Awesome, man.
And that invite goes to anybody, too. We're always looking for guest writers over at howtogrowamustache.com.
Yeah, and if you guys haven't heard, Christian's interview with the barber is really cool. I dug that one. So.
Mini's Barbershop, yep.
Yes.
Thank you.
And, David, where can people find you out in the computer world?
definitely not there. You can find me on YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram under SoSharpDavid, and SoSharpLimited.com.
Awesome. And Douglas, where can people locate you at?
People can locate me at PhoenixArtisanAccoutrements.com. See, it's at the bottom there. Or yes. HowToGrowMustache.com or... let's see, crownkingshaving.com or Facebook. I'm all over social media, people.
Yes.
You can find me if you want to. I'm very, very accessible.
Very easy. All you need to do is go to Google.
Super easy.
G-O-O-G-L-E and type in Douglas Smythe or How to Grow a Mustache or Phoenix Artisan, and he'll pop up. It's insane. He's everywhere.
But before I take off, I really want to say, if you guys haven't tried this tea yet, I don't know if there's a lot of tea drinkers out there. Have you seen this?
No.
Tea of a kind. It's called Tea of a Kind. And see this lid right here? When you unscrew that, the tea is right here. It's all up in there. This is water. And you turn that and it shoots out into it.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it's brewed and stored in this little cap, and then so you unscrew it, that happens, and it's still not open yet, so you can shake it up, and then you have this freshly blended brewed tea. It's awesome stuff, tea of a kind. It's in like all the supermarkets in Arizona right now, and I can't get enough of this stuff. It's pretty safe to say I'm addicted to it, and now look at me, I'm pushing it. God damn it, try this!
But please do not admit to being a teetotaler. Please do not admit
no,
that.
No.
And as always, well. Guys, as always, guys, you can find me on Instagram at rcorner or Twitter as Rico's Corner or YouTube. And if you want to find me on Facebook, just message me, and I'll tell you where you can find me because things have changed in the Facebook world. But, yeah, thanks for being a part of the show. We really appreciate you guys watching every week. And you can tweet to us at WS Roundtable. Let us know what's going on in your world with shaving. Please join the How to Grow a Mustache Movember team. If you're in Canada, join that one. If you're in the U.S., join the U.S. team. And fantastic stuff. If you guys have any questions, please let us know, and I hope you have a great week. We'll talk to you later. See ya.
High five.
All right, we are off air, I think.
Dude, I didn't mean to throw you off by saying cock blocker on the show.
Oh, no, you're great. And actually, hold on a second. We still might be live.
That's okay.
Hey guys, I gotta take off.
All right,
so
man.
You guys have a good one. Hey, Christian, look forward to seeing you soon, man.
Yeah, same
flush
here.
The toilet, dude. Flush the toilet.
You're stupid.
Thank God for there's no smell of vision.
David, light a match.
Hey, dude, maybe that is something. Like, Soapy Bathman just released this oil to put on top of the toilet to hide your turd smell. But maybe a bathroom toilet. Exists. Maybe a bathroom candle from, PAA. That would be interesting because I use it once in a while. We have guests at our house, and I've been in there and, you know, dropped the deuce, dropped a couple of the boys at the brown pool. the candle would be good because the candle I have now, what was that company called? American Yankee?
Yankee Candle.
Yeah, it just stinks.
That's
man.
That's where I grew up. I was making mandals.
Oh, mandals.
But,
okay.
Yeah, I haven't perfected it yet. I was using wooden wicks because I was trying to keep it natural, but I just don't have time. But yeah, but I do. I would like to do one with all my popular scents, do mandals. But that stuff that Soapy Bathman came out with, that already came out. I think it's called Poo-Pourri.
Yeah.
If you remember when I interviewed Joe from Italian Barber on the podcast, we were talking about how he picks them up, and this is a few years back, but I guess they were selling on TV. It was all the rave. It was funny to see that. It's like, wow, that's pretty random, Chris. Like, I don't understand the.
I agree completely. Came from. It was random. I remember watching the video. I thought it was just a viral video. It's a natural product. It's a blonde girl that looks like Meghan Trainor, about all that, you know, that the pop singer from All About That Bass. She's from Massachusetts too. They just put this oil on top of the toilet and hide your crap.
Yeah.
It's like, wow, that's a lot of procedure, you know. But anyway, you could always do
it. Does well. I'm curious to see what Chris is going to do with it. I think it's amazing. Do you know what sense he's doing in it? I can't even see myself using this.
I have no idea, but you know what? I have. I may be ordering some shampoo bars from him, and I want to order your shampoo bars too because you have like the 2-in-1. You have the conditioner, which would nullify my, apple cider vinegar and distilled water and essential oil concoction. So I'm interested in that because, there is an oil that you use in there that – well, you do have apple cider vinegar in yours, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so
that's
that's
another thing. You can use that instead of a liquid alum as a deodorant as well. You can use apple cider vinegar too.
Oh, okay.
FYI.
Yeah, that's true. And when it dries, it doesn't have a smell. Yeah, that's true. Because I know when I do my conditioner now, like right now I have a what's the scent that I have? I think I have tangerine essential oil and – it smells like some kind of like salad dressing, right? Because of the vinegar smell. So.
That's funny.
But, that's cool.
Definitely pick up
a couple of drinks during the show. I had some root beer.
Oh yeah.
I had some Asahi Black. I had some Lagunitas. So.
Anyway. Gee, I can't even keep up with that. I had a gin and tonic, and I had some tea. But I want to know how that is. When you pick up Chris's soap bars, body bar, or shampoo bars, pick that stuff up. What is he calling it?
Oh, I forget what it's called, but I remember when he launched it. It was just when, you know, the whole Movember thing in Canada happened, and I we flanked him on both sides to get him to join the team. Yeah. And he had just launched. That was my opening line to him. He said, "Oh, I hope it does well, you know." But yeah, I don't think he even talks about the smell of it. It's just the oil. So it's like, well, geez, I might as well just pour, you know, a quarter of a cup of olive oil on the toilet before I dump one.
Excuse me for 1 second, Chris.
Yeah.
Yo. It's David. David's telling me the show's still alive.
Oh,
is it really? Like, he's telling me, don't say anything stupid. I don't think I have, so have I? Oh, no. Yeah, exactly. Okay, right on, man. Thanks. Thanks for the warning. Okay, I'll take care of it. Ciao. Hello, folks. Apparently, we are still live. I have no idea what happened. I'm sorry for that. And I have no idea how to turn this thing off. Since I don't know. Did Rico have to leave, Chris? Is that what happened? Or
yeah, I think so. I think the only way
this
to
is the
down is for us to log
we
off.
We have to say goodbye. Yeah, this folks, I'm sorry if we said anything weird. I don't think we did. But this is the green room. This is the after the show. There's a before the show green room thing we do as well, which is pretty much us just shooting the shit. And that's what you just witnessed. So this is a little peek behind the scenes. I know it doesn't look that much different than the show. And I really am now I'm rewinding what I said. What did I say? I think it was cool. We should sometimes play that up one of these days. Yeah. Excellent. Okay, Christian, well, I'll talk to you really soon. And everyone else out there that stuck around with us, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next week. Tally-ho!